to our fine sponsors, New Look Boutique, Antique, and Salon, Raising Cane's out of Laurel, and our fine friends over at Kim's Nissan. Kim's Nissan does a great job, and we really appreciate them. So we'll be back from the word after these fine. Well, actually, here's a little Chuck Berry for you. Run, Rudolph, run. And a little Chuck Berry for you on the 5th day of December, waiting for the big guy to come on the 25th. I'm looking forward to it. And remember our fine sponsors, Kim's Nissan, Lucas Tax Service, Raising Cane's. Remember, they've got those cool Raising Cane 3 calendars they're giving away. Oh, actually, they're selling $2 a piece. Go by there and see any of the team members there through the drive-thru or when you go in. And remember, Lucas Tax Service and Kim's Nissan and New Look Boutique, Antique, and Salon. So remember those fine sponsors. So we have some sports news for you. Let's look over the Week 14 power rankings. And this is through Week 14, what happened last week. We'll give you the first five teams. Okay, the Los Angeles Rams come in this week at the number one spot with an 11-1 record. The New Orleans Saints come in at the number two spot with a 10-2 record. The Saints took one on the chin last Thursday at Dallas, 13-10. The Kansas City Chiefs are doing well at 10-2 as well. Patrick Mahomes is doing a fine job there in his rookie season. The New England Patriots, what do you expect? They're 9-3. And so they're doing a fine job there. And the Los Angeles Chargers, 9-3. So the Houston Texans are at 9-3 at number 6. The Pittsburgh Steelers are coming in at number 7 with a 7-4-1 record. The Saints will have them in a week. So that'll be a tough game. The Chicago Bears at 8-4. Da Bears. The Seattle Seahawks at 7-5 at number 9. And at 10, 7-5 Baltimore Ravens. So there you have it, folks. That's the top 10 NFL teams. I'm not going to go through the whole list of 32 because that would be cliche. You can look that up. And tonight we've got a big basketball game out in West. One of my favorite teams, the Gonzaga Bulldogs, the number one team in college basketball, will be taking on Washington, the Washington Huskies, UW at 6-2. This week, the Saints take on the Buccaneers. The Buccaneers are 6-7, and the Saints are 10-2. You can catch that game on Fox at noon. The Eagles will be taking on the Cowboys at 3:25 on Fox. And so that should be some good football. Looking forward to that. That's going to be a lot of good football to watch. And the top story in college football today is that Kelly Bryant chooses Missouri to transfer to. He had a whole list of schools, about 6 schools. And I don't understand this. I mean, if these athletes nowadays don't get their way, they transfer. I mean, what happened to competition? I thought competition made you better. You know, they really need to understand that they just need to put in the time and work. That's what it boils down to. If they work and put in the time, then they'll be awarded in life. And so that's what they need to do. So we give I don't know. I'm not going to get on that soapbox because I could sit here and talk about it all day about how, pitiful that is. But that's just me. I mean, I'm just keeping it real. Also, Mississippi State won last night against McNeese. They were down by 3 at halftime, 42-39, and come back to win 90-77. So, very good there. LeBron proud his son makes LA debut wearing number 23. I tell you, ain't that something? LeBron James Jr.'s basketball debut in Los Angeles went better than his dad's did. The 14-year-old who goes by Bronny scored 27 points in his first game for Santa Monica Crossroads 8th grade basketball team in a win over Culver City Middle School on Monday. Bronny wore number 0 while playing on the AAU circuit because of his affinity for Russell Westbrook. Surprised the Los Angeles Lakers superstar by wearing his dad's number 23 for his new team. I don't know how long it's going to last, but it definitely made me feel proud, James said of his son's number switch after Lakers practice Tuesday. So there you go. How about that? Give the young man credit. He's honoring his dad by doing that. You know, it is what it is. So that's our sports news. And again, thank our fine sponsors, Kim's Nissan, Flicka's Tax Service in Taylorsville, New Look Antique Boutique Salon down there in downtown Laurel, and Tomley Christmas Tree Farm. So come by those fine spots. And let's take a break. And hey, we talked about this yesterday. This song's banned in a radio station in Ohio, and I think in Arizona. But it's not banned on our show, so let's listen to a little Baby It's Cold Outside.
I really can't stay. But baby, it's cold outside. Got to go away. But baby, it's cold outside. This evening has been hoping that you drop in. So nice. I'll hold your hands, they're just like
my
ice.
My mother will start to
beautiful, worry. What's your
heart? Father will be pacing the floor.
Listen to the fireplace
so
roar.
Really, I'd better
beautiful,
hurry.
Please don't
well,
hurry.
Maybe just a half a drink.
Put
more.
Some records on while I
the
pour.
Might
baby, it's bad out there.
Say, what's in the
no
drink?
Cabs to be had out there.
Wish I knew
your eyes are like starlight now. I'll take your hat, your hair looks
I
swell.
Say, no, no,
mind
no,
if I move in close?
At least I'm gonna say that I
tried. What's the sense of hurting my pride?
Really,
well, baby, don't hold out. Baby, it's cold outside.
Go.
But baby, it's cold outside.
The answer is no.
But baby, it's cold outside.
The welcome has
how
been
lucky that you
so
dropped
nice
in.
And warm.
Look out the window at the storm.
My sister will be suspicious.
Gosh, your lips look
my
delicious.
My brother will be there at the door.
Waves upon the tropical shore.
My maiden aunt's mind is
gosh, busy. Your lips are delicious.
Well, maybe just a cigarette.
Never such a blizzard before.
I've gotta get home.
But baby, you'd freeze out there.
Say, lend me a coat.
It's up to your knees out there.
You've really been
I
grand.
Thrill when you touch my
but
hand.
Don't you see?
How can you do this thing to me?
There's bound to be talk tomorrow.
Think of my lifelong
at
sorrow.
At least there will be plenty implied.
If you caught pneumonia and
I really can't stay.
Get over that old doubt. Baby, it's cold. Maybe it's cold outside.
Now, see, there's nothing wrong with that tune. I mean, it's a classic tune. I love that song. I mean, it's a great song. And so, going into the weird news, odd news, a painting bought at a thrift store auctioned for $34,025. How about that? What a lucky buy here. A Netherlands man is enjoying an unexpected windfall after a painting he bought for $85 at the thrift store sold for $34,000. Hank Learmans bought the painting at a thrift store for $85 and decided to take it to an expert at Tussin Kunst and Kitsch. The expert identified the piece as A Sunny Day in the Dunes, a painting by artist Johan Arts. The expert said the pointless work of painting where the picture is formed by a series of dots could prove highly valuable. The appraiser's prediction was proven true Monday when the painting sold for $34,000 at an auction. Auctioneer Pete Van Witten said the painting was purchased by an anonymous Dutch collector. Wow. Isn't that lucky? I mean, I would never get that lucky. I mean, a guy, I mean, ain't that something? A guy buys a painting for $85, then turns around and gets $35,000 for it. I tell you. Isn't that something? How about this? How about this headline, people? A cabbage buying errand leads to $225,000 jackpot. Yeah, that's right. A Maryland woman whose father sent her to the store for a head of cabbage ended up with plenty of green. $225,000 from a scratch-off lottery ticket. Vanessa Ward told Virginia lottery officials her father asked her to pick up a head of cabbage. So she stopped by the giant food store in Groveton and decided to buy a win and spin scratch-off ticket while she was there. The ticket earned Ward the top prize, a chance to spin the wheel at Virginia Lottery headquarters and win between $100,000 and $500,000. She won $225,000. She said she plans to put the money toward her retirement and take a possible trip to Disney World. Congratulations, Vanessa. See now, you know, that's some good and fun news. And